Good morning, students. Today we are going to start with the poem The Voice of the Rain from your hornbill. Now I would request you all to open your books and open page number 41 so that you can refer the poem as and when we are going to note down few of the important aspects within the poem. So let us start with some information about the poem Walt Whitman. Okay, let us start with some information about the poet Walt Whitman. Walt Whitman was born on 31st May 1819. He was an American poet, essayist, journalist and humanist. He used unusual images and symbols in his poetry. He was often called the father of free verse. Now let us look about some more information about him. He was born in Huntington in Long Island. Whitman worked as a journalist, a teacher, government clerk and was a volunteer nurse during an American Civil War. Whitman's work breaks the boundaries of poetic forms and is generally prose-like. He was deeply influenced by deism. He denied the fact that one faith was more important than the other and embraced all religions equally. So he believed in a manner that all the religions have equal worth, they are equally worthy, and this was his own philosophy. Now let us move towards the poem here. This poem is basically based on, as we can see in the title, that The Voice of the Rain. So rain is a life giver and lends enchanting beauty to the earth with its resonance of sound. The poem is a joyous celebration of the arrival of the rain. So let us move further. I am going to explain the poem here. As we understand, this poem is a free verse. It is does not have a rhyming scheme being followed. So in the very first, see, first of all we have to understand that the poem is in a conversation tone. That means the poet is going ahead having a conversation with rain. Now rain being a non-living element of the nature, we cannot talk to the rain. So here the poet has thematically, he has used personification as a thematical poetic device where he has personified the rain and he is asking a question to rain. Where when he first put up his question over there, he finds a reply which he can sense and he is giving his words to the reply which he received from the rain. That means the poem moves on in the initial lines. These are the replies, these are the explanation as an answer to the question being put up by the poet in front of rain. And this question was answered by the rain in its own sound, and the poet has given his words so that it could be understood by the reader, by us. Now let us start here with the poet inquires of falling raindrops as who it is. So those raindrops which are been falling, the rain which is coming and the raindrops which are there, so he is just asking who you are, who the rain is. Surprisingly, he receives a reply. A reply was being received by the poet, and this was a very stunning, surprising factor which he did not actually expected out of the rain. The rain replies that it is the poem of the earth. What the first reply of the rain is that rain is the poem of the earth. It is the way, the song in which the earth sings, that is the rain. Okay, so here it is an extended metaphor which is being used as a poetic device by the poet. The rain describes its journey, how it rises intangibly out of the land. Now, rising intangibly, that means how this is here, the poet is describing the water cycle here, that is the scientific fact, water cycle. In this poem, he is explaining that how the intangible form of rain, that means the water vapors, they are intangible, we cannot touch them, they are not solid state, they are just being felt. Anything which we cannot touch, which is not physically seen, visible, but they are present, we can feel them, those are intangible things. So the poet says what the rain describes, that its journey starts, how it rises intangibly as vapor out of the land and sea and floats up to heaven. So from the surface of the sea, from the water bodies, from the land, wherever the source of water is there, the water vapors are rising up and they are reaching the heaven. Heaven is here being a symbol of sky, it is reaching up here, and where it changes its form and becomes a cloud. In the sky, what happens? These water vapor, they change their form, they build up and they takes different forms, and finally they become clouds and they take the form of a rain, water leaded clouds which are having water in them. Yet the rain remains the same in its heart as it was at its birth. So from where the birth has taken place, from the water bodies, from the earth, and that same water, though in a different form, in the form of water vapor, is as in the form of a cloud, but inside the heart of that cloud, the water remains the same. It is the same thing which has risen from the earth, and now it has taken the form of a cloud. So this is how it has described in the few initial lines. Now let us move further here. Then it falls back to the earth to refresh the drought-filled land, allowing seeds to grow into something vital and beautiful. Now what exactly is happening here is, after the clouds are being formed and those clouds are laden with water, these clouds, the rain, they just completely, that rain happens and the water falls down on the land and it comes back to the earth. It has been returned back to the earth in the form of raindrops. Now the falling of rain, how it affects, what are the various effects which are being shown by the poet, how it impacts the earth. What happened? A drought-filled land is refreshed. Every land, piece of land which has been facing a drought time during the summers before the rain, that has been completely drenched, wet by the falling of raindrops. And then what happens after the rain has been there on the surface? The next thing will happen is the growth of those seeds which were being dormant, which were up till now, they were being lying lifelessly on the earth, but now with the falling of the earth, they get the life nourishing from the water which has been there because of the presence of rain, and that is how these seeds which were up till now, they were being lifeless, gains the nourishment from water and then they grows. The little water droplets bring respite to us, rejuvenate the earth's soul and wash away the dust and air. Now see the various things which this rain is doing here. What it is doing? It brings respite. We feel very peaceful, very refreshing when the rain comes. It rejuvenates the earth's soul. Earth's soul, which was being totally drought, which was the victim of drought, which was facing intense heat of the summers, has now been rejuvenated. It has been re-energized because of the raindrops and washes away the dust and the dirt. What all the dirt and dust has been there on every corner of the earth is being totally washed up. Everything becomes neat, clean, clear. The environment becomes clean. The presence of as minutest parts of the dust is being washed by this water. So basically it is rejuvenating the complete ecology, environment of the earth. The earth is the creator of the rain and it gives back life to it. So this is the earth which has actually created the rain. The rain has the water vapors which have risen from the earth itself. Now they are returned back in the form of rain and it gives back life to it. Now this rain is basically giving the life back to the earth. It makes the globe wholesome and beautiful. Because of the presence of the rain, the life has become wholesome and it has regained the lost beauty which was because of the intense heat which was experienced during the summers before the rain. Okay, now let us move further to the next few lines in the poem here. The speaker equates the role of the rain to the poet's role in crafting this song. As the poet describes that rain is the poem of the earth, so he is comparing a song with the rain. Here again there is a metaphor. Okay, so what he is equating the role of rain to the poet's role in crafting this song. The way the poet creates a song, in the same manner the earth has created rain. Now in once the poet has created the song, it has given him a satisfaction, feeling of completeness, and it has rejuvenated the poet. So in the same fashion, the creation of rain has also made the earth, it has, because of rain only, the life is been back on the earth. He goes on to write that song is born in the poet's heart. The way the rain is being born from the surface of the earth, in the same manner the poem, the song, has taken birth in the heart of the poet. Okay, it leaves the poet's soul and changes form, but is always the same at its core. Now what exactly is happening? The poem or the song which was being created by the poet leaves the poet. It moves further, it is being read, it is being further recited by number of people, and then all those people who are reciting, they are enjoying the that soul of the creation of the poet, and this is how it changes the form. But over the time when this song, this poem has been recited by many people in various rhythms, then though the form has been changed, but the basic theme or the crux of that poem remains the same. The core of the poem, the song, it will remain the same and eventually returns to the poet as love from his reader. Now what exactly has happened? This song is coming back to the poet. He is receiving back the love of the readers the happiness, the gladness which a reader has experienced is been returned back to the poet, and that love is actually been received by the poet because of his own creation. The way the earth, when it receives the rain back, it gives life to the earth, in the same manner the song is also coming back to the poet in this as the love of the readers. Okay, so now let us move further here with next few more lines. See, there are last few lines which are being written by the poet in bracket. They are not being the part of the main poem. Why it is so? Because the poet has been into the conversation. Up till now, the poem was in a conversational mode, and he was replying on the, he was giving words to the reply he received from rain. So, since this part which is in the bracket is not the part of that conversation, that is why he has mentioned those lines, last few lines in the bracket, because it is not the part of the conversation between the poet and the rain. Okay. The poem is an extended metaphor that we have already understood, that the poem of the earth is being given, is being imagined as the rain. Rain replies here that it is the poem of the earth. So, here it is an extended metaphor. The poet describes rain as the poem of the earth. The poem is the conscious effort of the poet to describe rain through the metaphor of a song. In the last few lines before the bracket, he has clearly described how he has compared rain with the song created by a poet. So, this is how it is an extended metaphor. Now, as we understand here, the poem is an artistic representation of the scientific fact of the water cycle. As I was discussing it earlier, the poem describes the complete different phases of water cycles, how the water vapor, the vapors, they rise from the earth's surface, they become, they take the form of the cloud, then they again rain, brings rain to the earth's surface, and finally the water is being back, returned back to the earth. So, this is basically a scientific process, water cycle, which has been beautifully and in a literary manner in the form of a poem here is being described by the poet. It is compared to a song starting from its origin and coming back. So, basically it is a creation which starts from its origin, and finally after taking different forms in between, they are coming back to the right, to the creation, they are being returned back. Okay. So, now let us move further here, that how the song that arises in one's soul comes back to the singer to bless him or her, to bring spiritual fulfillment to the singer. Now, the basic thing which he gains out of this complete creation of poem being taking, being recited by different people over the time, the readers, they are reading the poem, and finally what is the gain is the spiritual fulfillment, a feeling of satisfaction is being attained by the poet giving his own creation to the human beings, to the human race, and that gives him a spiritual fulfillment. Similarly, the rain that started on the land and in the sea comes back to bless the earth, bringing the same spiritual fulfillment. Now, this is here he has compared the song with the rain. How it exactly is being compared? The similarity is being established that the rains is started on the land. Water vapors have risen from the land surface, from the surface of the earth, from the sea, from the other water bodies, and they have taken different forms in the manner they became clouds, and finally they are being, they come back to the earth surface in the form of rain. टू ब्लेस द अर्थ ब्रिंग द सेम स्पिरिचुअल फुलफिलमेंट, दैट इज द बेसिक थिंग विच इट ब्रिंग्स बैक. इट रिजुविनेट्स द अर्थ, इट री एनर्जाइजेस द अर्थ एंड इट ब्रिंग्स a spiritual fulfillment is being given in the form of new life which blooms with the presence of the rain on the when it drops on the surface of the earth. It gives a clear washed, a clear environment, dust free environment where every life form is being nourished because of the presence of the rain. So this is how the poet has beautifully described this complete water cycle in this manner. Okay, now let us move towards the critical analysis of this poem here. Now here the voice of the rain is written in free verse. Free verse means there is no rhyming scheme is being followed here in the various lines of the poem. It does not follow any rhyming scheme. It is an extended metaphor. This we have discussed earlier also. The poet has written in one stanza with 9 distinct lines. There are 9 different lines in one single stanza, which has been a form of a reply being received by the poet from the rain. When in the first line he asks the question to the rain, who it is? That is the question which was asked by the rain, by the poet to the rain, and the reply was being received by him, which he has narrated in his own words. In the first 2 lines, the poet questions the rain, who it is. The rain's response makes up the remaining 6 lines. So in the remaining 6 lines, the received reply received by the poet is being narrated by the poet from the on behalf of the rain. The last lines of the poem are kept in bracket as they do not belong to the conversation between the poet and the rain, that we have discussed earlier also, that these are being put up into the bracket just because they are not the part of the conversation between the poet and the rain. Okay, now a bit more that how the poet Whitman, he has compared the song and the rain, which demonstrates is transcendental beliefs. Okay, rather than associating his poetry with something modern, transcendental means the basics, the basic aspects which are very natural things. Okay, he has not taken any modern aspects of the life. He has just compared a very primitive part of human culture, that is the song, that is the poet, with a element of nature, that is rain. So these 2 basic elements of the human life are being compared by the poet here. Rather than associating his poetry with something modern and man-made, he chooses to associate it with the eternal cycles of the natural world. So basically he has dealt with the cyclic movement of water in this poem. Okay, now let us move towards the next part of this critical analysis. In this poem, Whitman turns to one of the most ordinary sights of all, the rain, and receives a vision of cosmos. Cosmos means the universe. Okay, now what exactly is happening here? This is the basic philosophy or the thematic approach of the poem, which we can understand here, that he turns one of the most ordinary sights of all, the rain. The rain, which is a very ordinary thing which happens just like that in every year we have rains, those ordinary rain droplets he has received a vision of the cosmos. Those rains are basically the cosmic element which is being described by the poet here. The poet tells us about the endless journey of a drop of moisture from the land or sea, evaporating into the air, rising up into the sky to condense into the clouds, and then to fall back as a shower. So that means the complete cycle is being described here how it has originated, how the earth has created that water droplet, becomes water vapor, reaches the sky, becomes a cloud, takes different forms, then laden with water, it comes back in the form of rain droplet, and finally completing its, fulfilling its complete journey. And this is the cyclic movement, an eternal thing which has been always been there since the existence of the earth, and it will keep on moving in the same cyclic manner till the earth exists. So it is an eternal thing over there. Okay, now let us move to the next aspect here. Through this cycle, the scientific fact that energy is never destroyed and only transferred from one form to another is re-established. This is also a re-establishment of the fact, of a scientific fact, that energy transforms from one form to another form, and it has never been created nor been destroyed. So that is what exactly is being re-established. It has been re-described in a poem by this poet. The rain beautifies the earth with its shower, purifying it in its, in that particular process. So basically the complete earth get purifies, get clear of all the dust and the dirt in the cyclic manner, in the cyclic process, and every time whenever this cycle happens, it rejuvenates, it brings the life back, and the dead things get nourishment, get water again, and they are being lively, they become full of life. Okay, now the very important part of the poem, that is, that are the poetic devices. Now, as we have already discussed the poetic devices, the very first poetic device here is the personification. Personification is a figure of speech wherein human qualities are given to animals, objects or ideas, whatever is like lifeless things. It means representing a non-human thing as if it were a human. So basically that is personification, and here the rain is personified and shown as responding to the questions of the poet. We know that rain is a non-living element of the nature, but then too the poet has assumed, it has personified the rain as someone who answers his question. Okay, now another poetic device, that is another important one, that is the metaphor. The rain is to person who lives its home, leaves its home and comes back after fulfilling the his journey. So it is a metaphor. Now here, I am the poem of the earth, said the voice of the rain. This is the second line of the poem where the answer is being given. Sorry, the third line. I am the poem of the earth, said the voice of the rain. So here, this is an extended metaphor. Extended metaphor will come even in the last few lines, where there will be a comparison between the poem of the earth, that means the rain, and the song created by the poet. That will be the extended metaphor. Here it is the first metaphor from the poet, that the rain is being compared to the poem or the voice of the earth. Okay, now let us move to the next part here of the poetic devices. Another poetic device is paradox. Paradox means using the statements which are self-contradicting. That means they are countering each other. And because it often contains two statements that are both true, but in general both cannot be true at the same time. So what exactly is, sorry, the two statements here which are being contradicting with each other. Like here, look in line number 12, day and night. Both day and night are truthfully existing here. Both the statements are true, but then too they cannot exist at the same time. So here the paradox is being used. Similarly, in the last line, reckoned and unreckoned. So reckoned and unreckoned, both the understand, you are understanding it and you are unable to understand, both the things cannot happen at the same time, but the poet is using the contradicting statements at the same time. So here you get the examples. You can mark paradox in line 12, day and night, and last line, reckoned and unreckoned. Okay, we have 2-3 more here. We have you poetic devices which are to be discussed, like simile. Simile is another poetic device which is being used in last two lines in the poem, where rain is like song of the poet. See here, the last two lines, here the simile is being used by the poet. And similarly, another poetic device, hyperbola, is being used, that is the exaggeration of a particular thing is being done by the poet, like here, the bottomless sea. Look into the line, see here, from the line, yes, 6. Sorry, look into line 4. Line 4, see this phrase is being used, bottomless sea. Every sea has a bottom. Here there is an hyperbola, exaggeration of the same aspect is being used, that the sea is not having seabed, that is the hyperbola. Okay, one more poetic device is being used here, that is imagery. The poet has used this poetic device very beautifully in various lines. See, in the very first line, soft falling shower drizzle, soft falling shower drizzle. What exactly happens here is an image has been created, a complete view, a picturization of how the rain is been falling. It is falling softly on the surface of the earth. So that is how the image is being created by the poet in these words. Similarly, you can also find imagery in line 4. Heaven forms cloud. See here. In line 4, upward to heaven, winds vaguely formed, together changed and yet the same. So he is describing the formation of cloud. Another image has been created by him here also. Another poetic device, oxymoron, is also being used here, and paradox is there in line 12 and in the last line also. Okay, so here this is how oxymoron and paradox, both the poetic devices, deal with opposite ideas, being the contrasting ideas which are being projected at in the same line, where the both the ideas cannot exist, both the ideas are true and they cannot exist at the same time. So in this manner we have discussed the various poetic devices which are being used. One of the thing which is being also being discussed here is extended metaphor, where the poet's song is being compared to the poem of the earth, that is the rain. This is an extended metaphor. Okay, now let us move towards the theme of this poem. What is the thematic approach with which the poet has written the poem? The poem is an artistic representation of the scientific fact of the water cycle, which is compared to a song starting from its origin and coming back. So basically, this is a cyclic description of how the water moves from the earth's surface and returns back to the earth's surface. It is the conscious effort of the poet to describe the rain through the metaphor of the song. So basically, thematic poetic device, metaphor, that means the song is being compared with the rain as the voice of the earth. The hidden meaning of the poem is the song arises in one's soul and comes back to the singer to bless him or her, to bring spiritual fulfillment to the singer. So basically, the song gives the way it gives the spiritual fulfillment. In the similar manner, the rain, which is created by the earth, when it is coming back to the earth in the form of rain, it gives a spiritual fulfillment to the earth. Similarly, the rain that started in the sea comes back to bless this earth bringing the same spiritual fulfillment to the earth. So this is the basic thematic approach here. Hopefully we have dealt with all the basic important and significant aspect of this particular poem. I would say you that you practice the extracts based questions from the poem and do the copy work, and whatever the doubts you are finding while you are dealing with the poem as well as with the copy work, you can ask those doubts, you can clarify those doubts in the live doubt session. I hope you will be taking good care of yourself. Stay home and stay safe. Thank you, students.